Hello guys, welcome to another 2JZ 2sday. My name is Michael Chung, and today I'm going to talk about is compression ratio. The part one I'll be talking about is compression ratio for all general engines. And then part two, I'll be talking about the 2JZ GTE and the GE comparison. First of all, we need to understand a few terms, okay? Which is total volume. The total volume is when the pistons travels to the most bottom, we call it bottom dead center. Then this whole volume, we call it the total volume, all right? Swept volume is the volume of the air that is swept, that means that is compressed or that is pulled in by the piston. Okay, it is calculated by pi d squared over 4. D is the ball of the piston times stroke. This is just a formula for cylinder. Alright, so this one is the swept volume. And then when the piston travels to the top dead center, and this volume, we call it the clearance volume. Okay, it is caused by the piston recess, the head gasket, and then the top part of the cylinder head. Okay, all these add together become the clearance volume. But all this only can be measured. Okay, very hard to calculate that. So it only can be measured by using liquid alcohol or a displacement test. So the total volume is equal to this swept volume plus this clearance volume. Alright, so if you guys understand this, then you can understand the next one. We call it the compression ratio. It is actually the total volume divided by the clearance volume. But if you see from this formula, actually it is just pi times ball squared times stroke divided by 4 plus clearance volume divided by clearance volume. Okay, so the next video I'll be explaining more about this formula and then what we can do to increase the compression ratio or reduce it. Alright, so let's explore why we go for high compression ratio or why we go for low compression ratio. Alright, so for high compression ratio, it is good for high efficiency, because higher compression ratio, you can think of it as a compression ratio or expansion ratio. Expansion ratio, if you have more, then you can get reduced exhaust temperature. That means higher mechanical efficiency. For a less amount of fuel, you can get more mechanical energy. This is what we want. Alright, and high compression ratio, you can get a very fast response engine. In a low RPM, it can rev up very fast. Okay, this is what we want too. Okay, but we also want low compression ratio because we want to add higher boost. Alright? So, because of you are adding more air and more compression, all the fuel inside the clearance volume, it may combust by itself. That means knocking. Knocking is what we don't want, because knocking is premature detonation. Before the spark plug is igniting, it is combusting by itself. That means it will cause engine wear and tear and engine damage. By having low compression ratio, we are also able to take lower octane fuel, okay? So called lower octane because we can take a RON 95 or 92 even, if we have very low compression ratio. But if we have high compression ratio, we have to either use a very high octane fuel or we replace the fuel into another fuel such as methanol or ethanol E85, which is very common in racing. So these two is a balance. All of these things we also want. We want high boost, we want high compression ratio for fast response, we want higher efficiency, we can save fuel. We want to resist knocking, we don't want knock. There are so many ways that we can maintain high compression ratio and high boost and able to take low octane fuel. This is what we in motorsports are always chasing for. So you may ask, how to increase the compression ratio or to reduce compression ratio? Okay, the easiest way is to see this formula. Okay, you can either increase your total volume, but this one I will be explaining in the next video. Okay, the clearance volume, you can reduce it. Okay, so clearance volume, what does it consist of is the cylinder recess. Okay, if you can reduce it by maybe skimming the cylinder head, or reducing the head gasket thickness, or increasing the piston dome shape, and reducing the clearance volume. So this is how you increase the compression ratio. And likewise, you reverse everything and you can lower down your compression ratio too for your high boost application. Okay guys, so stay tuned for the next video that I will be talking more about the 2JZ GTE and the GE compression ratio. This one I will be going in depth and talking about how does these two engines differ and how we can make use of them. Enjoy! We can see that the depth of this is much more than the NA. Okay, you can use a vernier to check it. About 14.8 mm, 11.1 mm. So what we can translate in CC is as below. Okay guys, press the like button if you guys like this video, and share with your friends if you think this video will benefit them. Subscribe for more videos and I will share more insights of 2JZ engine building. See you.